This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we created a new repository for our project. So now we can go ahead and create our new project inside of this new Git repository. If you are using GitHub Desktop and have created a new repository, you can now just select Open in Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code will open inside of your project folder there, and you can then start working. So this section here is now your project folder. If you were to simply navigate back here, you can now see that I've made a change inside of that folder. Right, so that's one way of opening up your project directly from GitHub Desktop, or you can simply just open up Visual Studio Code, go to File, Open Folder, and open the folder where you want to start building your project. Let's get the project started. First of all, we're going to install Django and DRF. Now, typically, when working with Django or a Python project, we work within the virtual environment. There is a setup guide at the start of this course, which will help you set up a virtual environment or take you through the process of starting the virtual environment within your operating system. First of all, let's go ahead and access the terminal. There are many ways to do that. View and terminal in the menu. You can see there's a shortcut here on the Mac and Windows. There's different shortcuts to open up the terminal window, but this is the terminal window right here. So once you've accessed that, you can then create a new virtual environment. Now, here I'm going to type in Py. If you're on Windows, you can just type in Py, but here I'm going to type in Python 3 and then VEMV. Before that, I'm going to need the M flag, VEMV. VEMV. So whether you're on Windows or Mac, that should work. Once you've done that, you can see here that we've now created a new virtual environment folder. Right, so once you've done that, let's go ahead now and activate our virtual environment. We're going to be working within this virtual environment, and that's going to help us contain all of the packages and build an environment that our application is going to work. We can now go ahead and activate the virtual environment. Whether you're on Windows or Mac, that's going to be slightly different. So here on the Mac, I'm going to type in source, and then I'm going to type in V, press tab to finish that, B, tab, A, and press tab again. So that's what we need there. So that's going to activate the virtual environment here on the Mac. If you're on a Windows machine, likelihood is that you'll just need to type in maybe .vmv, something like this, or just V. EMV slash, and then yours is going to be in script if you're on Windows, and then activate. So that's what's going to be typed in on a Windows machine. So here, like I said, we're going to type in source, and then that, and then that, and then that, activate. So you can see that it's activated because we have VEMV right here. So now we're working within the virtual environment. So let's go ahead and install Django first. So we're going to use the pip Python package manager, install Django. Let's give that a go first. If you're wondering where these downloads are coming from, they are being downloaded from the Python package index, a secure source for downloading Python packages. So if I just type in Django here and then select the top option, this is where we're installing Django from. And you can see the command that we used earlier. A quick tip, if you weren't already aware, if you have multiple lines here in your terminal and you want to quickly clear them, on Mac, you're going to press Command and K. If you're on Windows, you're going to type in CLS and press Enter. And that's just going to clear all the commands in the terminal. One thing to notice, even at this early point, is if you go back into source control here, you can see that Git has tracked all of the changes that we've made. So it's tracking all the new files and folders that have been created. And there's 6,045 of those changes. Now, what we've done so far is we have installed the virtual environment, and that isn't something that we want to track within our version control. So that is something that we actually want to tell our version control not to track. And we'll do that shortly, but let's just go back in here and create a new project, a new Django project. For that, we're going to type in Django admin. So this is a way of communicating with Django at this point, and then we're going to start a new project. So let's type in start project, and let's call this something. So we're going to call this project DJ Chat. Now you can call it whatever you like, of course. Now at this point, we've got a decision to make how we're going to structure this Django project. There are many ways to structure your code base in a Django project. Now, I'm not going to go through each one of those, but I just wanted to make you aware that you may come across different approaches or different project structures. Ultimately, the best way to structure your Django project depends on your specific needs and preferences. So it is definitely worth spending some time when you can, considering or exploring the options for structuring a Django project and working out what potentially is best for you or your team. In this course, we are going to utilize a default project structure provided by Django. Now, there's two options here we have, and let me just quickly show you this. So if I were to just follow through with this command here and press enter, you can see that Django is going to create a new project folder inside of my root directory. In actual fact, I'll do that again because I was in the wrong section there. So what I can do is I can press up and down on the keyboard, and you can see that brings up the previous command. So if I wanted to bring up the previous command, I just press up and down on the keyboard. That should bring up the previous command. Now, we didn't have a previous command for what we wanted to do, so I'm just going to type in Django admin again, start project, and then the project name, which is DJ Chat. So like I was saying, if we go with this and press enter, you can see what happens. We've created a new folder called DJ Chat. Inside of there, we have a project folder called DJ Chat. Okay, so that's our main project folder. Inside of here, you can see we have the settings. So this is where we're going to configure our application project-wide. And that's pretty much it. Now, in addition to that, creating a new project, you can see we've created a manage.py file. So this is an entry point. This is how we're going to communicate with Django through the manage.py file. We're going to see that shortly. So that's the first approach. I'm going to go ahead and just delete that folder. Another approach you can take is if you just wanted to use this project folder here for everything. So if I press it up again, but at the end here, I can specify where I want to create a new project. So if I specify dot, that dot represents this current directory that we're working in. Now, this terminal here is actually opened up within our project folder. So this terminal has navigated to our project folder. So anything I do here, in actual fact, can be manipulating our project folder. I'll show you that in a second. But let's utilize the dot here or full stop. So this approach here, you can see we have just a folder called DJ Chat, our main project folder, and you can see the manage.py file is right here. So we don't nest our DJ Chat folder with inside a folder called DJ Chat. So that's just two approaches that we can take to build a new project. So I'm going to now just delete DJ Chat folder that's been created and the manage.py. Okay, so with this project, we're going to be utilizing the first approach. So I'm going to press up twice and press enter. So you can see what's going to happen now is I've created a new folder called DJ Chat. Inside of there, we have a new project folder called DJ Chat. Now, just to show you what I meant previously about being in this location here. So this is our project folder right here, and our terminal opens inside of our project folder. So if I go into the terminal, just zoom in a little bit. So if I clear that, if I type in ls here, you can see I can see two folders, DJ Chat and the vent folder. So those are the two folders in actual fact that's right here inside of our project folder. So this just represents the fact that our terminal is actually in, or our terminal is placed within our project folder. And that's going to be important later on when we're navigating through our project and working with different technologies. So I can also type in DIR, for example, Windows, I think it is, and that will also show me all of the files and folders inside of that folder. Right, so now we've done that, let's go ahead and install DRF, Django DRF. Now, if you're not too sure how to install then you can just go over to the Python package index. Let's type in Django DRF, for example, here. And we can now see, or we're now presented, sorry, with a list of packages that we can install. Now, that isn't probably the best way. So Django REST framework. Let's give that a go. And you can see that there are a lot of different options here. And one of them isn't the Django REST framework. So we need to be careful to make sure that we're actually installing the correct package. So if you are presented with a massive list like this, and you're not too sure which one we need to install, then what you can do is sometimes use date of last updated, because it is a package that's going to be nicely updated. So that's one method. Alternatively, you're just going to type in Django REST framework into Google, right? And then find out, or find the documentation. So this is the documentation for the Django REST framework. And then typically there is a quick start guide. And then from there, we're told how to actually start utilizing Django DRF. So here we have it, install Django REST framework. So that's what we can type in. So let's give that a go. Let's go back. So pip install Django REST framework, that's going to install the Django REST framework. So before we finish, let's just make sure that everything is working successfully. Now, what we have here is a project folder, and you can see that our project, our DJ Chat or Django project, is inside of this DJ Chat folder. So in order for us to activate or manage our Django application, we're going to need to do that through manage.py. So to access manage.py, potentially we're going to need to move into this folder. We're going to need to move the terminal into this folder. And by doing that, or to do that, I need to type in cd, change directory. And then I can type in DJ chat, or just press DJ and press tab. And that then finishes that path. So if I press enter there, I can now type in ls. That takes me into that folder. And you can see that the terminal now has moved into that folder. So I can now access manage.py and run server. Okay, so I've typed in run server. That is a command that's going to create a new Django server. If I just move this up, or not, if I just go into the terminal here, we can see what's happened here is that Django started a terminal server, and here we're told the actual location of that server. So I'm going to copy that and then open up a new tab in my browser. So paste that into your browser, or just type in 127.0.0.1:8000, and you can now see that we have a message: the install worked successfully, congratulations. Notice that when we run a Django server, here in the terminal, we provided some additional information, and that relates to the interactions with our server. Now, when this is activated, we can't type in anything else into our server. We can type, but nothing happens. So we need to actually close the server in order to go back into the terminal so we can utilize the terminal. So we need to press Control. Actually, we're told right here. So to quit the server, we press Control and C. So that takes you back into the terminal so you can then continue working with the terminal.